Let's get started. Okay, so we're gonna start like we do every time, and I'm going to start my watch this time because I did not last time. Okay, so we're gonna start standing up, warm up those legs. You all know it all too well now, I'm sure. And if I've got any newbies, just follow along. I'll try and cue you through everything. Again, if you've got any pregnant people here, I didn't see any login, but if you are pregnant and watching this, you can do this entire class. So there shouldn't really be anything you can't do. Just take modifications and more breaks if you need to. And for everyone else, no breaks are allowed. Okay, let's get started. All right, come and stand up on your mat. Take your hands wherever is comfortable. We're just gonna start with squatting, okay? So just like normal, I like to bring my hands out into prayer as we squat down. Making sure our knees are tracking over our middle toes as we squat. So not letting them rock out or in. Protecting those knee joints, our hips, nice and level. Start to engage your core in this leg work, drawing that belly button in towards your spine, locking the rib cage in. And let's add that breath. Two more. Inhaling through the nose. Exhale, coming down, hold. Pulsing here. All right, so we're in our end range. Stick your bums back. All of your weight should be in your heels. All right, pulsing here. Keep moving. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold. You're gonna walk to the left-hand side, then step to the right and follow, okay? So we're just stepping side to side, but staying low. You're like a little sand crab. I know we all wish we were at the beach, especially us in our apartment. Now 5 more. Stay low. Can you sink any further back? Try to keep the chest up. 3. Hi, Emily from London. I hope you're not too drunk yet. Last 2. And 1. Hold here. Sink a little lower. Press the bum back. Sink into the heels. Your heels are going to lift up. And then lower back down. Inhale. Lift. Exhale. Lower. 8 more. Up. And down. We should feel those shakes. Char wanted these legs. You can blame her. Let's go. 4 more. 3. Last 2. There's too much shedding in those comments, girls. Let's get low. Last 1. You're going to hold the heels up. Eye gaze forward. Breathing. Sink low. Draw the belly button in. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're up. But not quite done. Okay. Should be feeling warm now. Let's draw the heels together. Toes pointing out. Okay. So I want the heels to be joined together, pressing really nice, and toes out either side. Hi, Sorsh. Hi, Nikki. Okay, if you're joining me, just join in from where we are. Okay, so draw those heels together. Hands are going to go on the hips. We're going to be working on the inner thighs with these squats, okay? So sinking down and standing. Try to keep the body reasonably upright. You won't go as low as normal in the squat. But try to sink the bum back. Again, tracking your knees over your middle toes. Press those heels together. I really want you to drive them together. Try to hurt your heels. Nice. 4 more. 3. Relax your shoulders. Open out through the collarbones. Last 2. We're coming and holding down low, of course. Hands come into a goalpost position. Palms facing each other. We open out. Draw in front. Just moving the arms. Sink your weight back into your heels. Press those heels together. Can you sink any lower? 5. Pull your belly buttons towards your spines. 4. Breathing. Don't you dare stand up. Last 2. Stay here. Hold. Pulse. 5, 4, 3. We're staying down. Hold. Heels lift. Don't stand up. You've got this. You've got this. Three more. No excuses. Leave them at the table. Last one. Hold the heels. Press them together. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're out of there. All right. Your legs should feel nice and warm. All right. Yes, if you can hear those background noises, because my wonderful flatmate's dying. Always good. Okay, we're gonna move into our standing lunges. So we've done these a few times now. We're gonna have a couple of different variations. Let's get into those glutes. Left leg's forward, right leg's back, okay? Really sink into that left leg. Right leg's all the way back, thinking of crown of the head to your toes. Hips are like headlights of a car, point them forward. Hinge the body forward, draw the belly in. Nice, when you're there. Right leg steps in and up. Hands can be in front or they can be on your hips or behind you, wherever is more comfortable. Having your hands out in front is a more challenging option. We're gonna go for 5, 4, 3. Hope you're all with me. Stay low into that left leg. Stick your bum out. 2. Last one. Hold here. I want you to hinge your body further forward. Take your hands out nice and long, tracking just by your ears. From here, your legs gonna stay still. You hinge from the hips, lower your chest down towards the ground, and lift back up. Hinging. And releasing. Slow this one down. Think about moving from the hips. 3 more. Last 2. Drop your shoulders away from the ears. 1. Hold that hinge. Take your hands behind your back or onto your hips. Really bring your weight into your left leg. We're going to lift the top leg. Toe tap and lift. All right. So just tapping and releasing. 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold here if you can. Reach a little further forward. Lift that leg up. If you can, reach your hands out in front. Holding 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Get out of there. Nice. How's that left glute? Mine, it's dying. Hold is also my least favorite word right now, as I've already done this today. All right. Right leg is going to be forward. Left leg is going to be back. Exactly the same as 4. I want you to hinge forward, draw the belly button in, stick that left leg back, diagonal line from the head to the top. Tap. Nice, keep tapping. I have something in my throat. Sink a little lower into that front leg, okay? Really hinge the body forward. Stick your bum out more than you think you need to. You're really trying to show someone your booty. All right, last 2. Last 1, let's take the leg back, hold here. Hands come out, hinge. And draw up. Using your breath here to help you. Movement is from the hips, guys. Really slow it down. 3. Can you sink a little lower into that right leg? 2. Last 1. Come into that middle position. Hold. Hands come back to the hips. We sink a little lower into that right leg. Your left leg lifts and lowers. Take the hands wherever feels comfortable with this one. Again, if they're out in front, that is harder. Toe tap down. 4, 3. Last 2. Hold here if you can. Bring those hands out in front. Hinge through the forward. Stick the bum out. 5, 4, 3, 2. And we're done. Shake it out. All right, your legs should be warm. We should be warmed up. We're all ready to go. Okay, come to the end of your mat. Either end. Sorry, I've got something in my throat today. Don't know what. All right. Come to the end of your mat. We're gonna just roll through the spine. So chin comes to the chest. Peeling through the spine, bone by bone. Rolling all the way down to the mat. As far as you can. Once you get there, re-step the spine. Lower back, mid-back, really curve your belly button into your spine, rounding, shoulders roll back. Again, let's roll through the spine. Chin to chest. Peeling, pull your belly button in as you curl over. Imagine you're curling over a ball, rolling through that spine. So if you've ever done reformer with me, you know that we'll do some core, legs, and spinal movement to warm up. So it's no different than the mat. Those legs are well and truly warm, your glutes are warm. Roll the shoulders back, one more, coming down. This time we hold at the bottom. Stacking the spine. Once you get down to the mat, try to bend your knees if you need to. So we need to get the fingertips down to the mat. If you can, keep the legs long. From there, you're gonna walk your fingertips forward. Keep the hips nice and level, come right out into your plank. And walk back. Try to keep those legs relatively straight. Take a little bit of a bend in them as you walk back, and then walk back out into our plank. Let's do this two more times. As you come into your plank, bring your shoulders right over your wrists. Belly button is drawn to your spine. Walking back now. And we're up. Hold here. Eye gaze forward, hips are nice and level. Your right leg is gonna draw across your body like a mountain climber. It comes back to the same arm as leg and then draws back. Okay, so it crosses, left leg crosses to right, goes back to left and returns. Let's try and get a little bit of pace. Draw in, cross, behind, in, cross, behind. Nice. Five, hips down, four, three, last two, hold. Hold that plank, your favorite word, drop the knees if you need to, eye gaze forward. Five, four, three, two, we're not moving. Walk into the bear crawl and out. All right, so we've done this one before. Final set here, keep moving. Eye gaze forward, don't you dare come down. Drop into that half plank if you need to. One more, hold that plank. Knee option if you need to. If you're taking that knee option, hinge those hips forward. Hold, five, four, three, two. Drop those knees, feet together, sink back. Take that nice child's pose. Nice deep breaths. Sorry, Charlotte, I can't deliver you a wheelchair, but I'm sure someone can. All right, take that nice stretch. Really reach the fingertips forward. Everyone should be feeling nice and warm now. Let's work those booties. All right, are you ready? Are you with me? Sorry, we've got one more thing before we go to the boot. So you're going to come into a four-point kneeling position, so your knees are underneath your hips. You're just going to warm up the back of the arms, okay? I want you to make a diamond shape with your hands. So on the mat, your hands will look like this. Nice little diamond. Knees are under the hips, okay? Draw the belly button into the spine. Keep those ribs nice and knitted. You're going to lower down your elbows to the mat. So it feels kind of weird. You feel like you're really close to your knees. Walk your fingertips out a little bit if you feel that. Slow drop down, elbows to the mat. Slow press up. So your body stays relatively still. It lowers with your arms, but we're not changing position through the hips. Nice. Slow down the breath. If anyone really wants to travel, challenge their triceps here. You can come into a full press. But this is more than enough. Let's go for three more. Who knew this little move can hurt so much? Last two. On one, come all the way down into a halfway position. Hold, pulse. Okay, so your elbows are just hovering off that mat. You're going up and down. Make sure that movement is coming from your arms. I do not want those hips bouncing up and down. It's not their job. Let's go for four, three, two, hold. Charlotte's favorite word. Let those elbows hover off. Eyes to your fingertips. And we're up. Shake those out. Nice. It's a little one you can do when you're watching telly. All right. Let's move into our glutes. So you're gonna come, I'll make sure that I'm really side on to you now. Okay, so let's do the left glute first. So we're gonna start with legs long. So I want your arm to be propped under you. So right arm's propped under. We're gonna come lying down. We're not gonna be in this position long for long. So do try to stay propped up. And your legs are gonna be nice and long. Okay, really draw through the obliques. I want you to lift up through that lower part of your body, and your shoulders should be over your elbow. Left hand's on the top of your hips. You're gonna use the hand to make sure this top hip doesn't rock. Okay, we're keeping it nice and still. Draw the belly button in. Those ribs should not be flaring, okay? Think about drawing them down towards your pelvis. Okay, top leg lifts up, same level as your hip. Okay, we're drawing a rainbow. It comes to the front of the mat, toe tap. Draw it up and over, toe tap the back of the mat. Okay, if you need to, take the left hand, place it in front of your body to prevent your ribs, or your hips, I should say, from rocking back and forward, okay? So just moving that leg. Nice. Keep your eye gaze forward. Just checking my comments. Hi, Kate. No, Maddie, that is not the end. Just beginning. Three. Two. Last one. You're gonna bring that leg in front. Plant the foot in front of your body. Just a little move for the inner thigh here. Okay, your bottom leg lifts and lowers. So keep pressing into your right elbow. Keep that side body lifted. Really small movements. Your foot's probably barely lifting off the ground. But if you put your hand on your inner thigh, you'll be able to feel that muscle contracting as you lift the leg. Then you know you're doing it right. Okay. Four. Three. Last two. And one. Hold it up. Little pulses. Pulse, 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 pulse. You got this. For five. Four. Three. Two. And one. All right. Draw those legs together. We're staying on the same side, but I want you to come down now, so that your hand is holding your head. If this is uncomfortable for your neck, you can actually lie down, okay? So take whichever option is more comfortable for you. I prefer to prop myself up. Again, left hand is on top of that left hip. I want you to make sure that that left hip doesn't roll back or forward. When you're ready, your feet lift up behind you. So they're off the mat. Left leg opens and we close it. So we're in our plan. So we've done this one, I think, before, so you should know what this feels like. We're warming up that left glute, we've already warmed it, but we're working into it a little deeper now. I want you to think about taking the movement only from the hip joint. So try not to use the knee to drive the movement. Use your hip to open and close. Tuck your bellies in. Are we all still breathing? In through the nose, out through the mouth. Four more. Three. Last two. On one, close it. Keep the feet lifted. Your left leg's gonna come up high. Draw it in towards your chest. Then press it all the way out nice and straight. Bends in towards your chest.
and presses out. Keep the belly nice and drawn in. Your body is staying as still as possible as you draw through that left side. Take the head down if it's getting tired. All right, I want you to try and stay with me through this whole set. I know that I can't see you, but really I can. So you should start to feel it switching on now. We've got three more here. Keep breathing. Last two. Last one, hold. The legs nice and long, point your toes, tiny circles with your foot. Nice, I'm just gonna move so you can see my feet. Dinner plate size. Three more. Last two. Last one, reverse that circle. Try to keep that bottom toe lifted off the mat as well. Makes it a little bit harder. Try not to let that top hip rock. Should be feeling a little fiery now. But if you want those peaches, you're staying with me. Hold. That leg is gonna stay lifted. You just flex your toes towards me. Point your toes. Flex and point. Nice, keep moving here. Flexing and pointing. Make sure that your toes and knee are on a diagonal, pointing up towards the ceiling, so not pointed down. Keep going. Don't you dare come out of this one. Let's go for four. It's meant to burn. Three. Last two. Point and hold. Draw up and down. Little pulses. Here's the finisher. Five. Four, three, two, hold it there, flex the toes towards your face. Hold. Can you lift your leg any higher? Five, four, three, two, one. Alrighty.
Give it a little tap out if you need to. Should be feeling very fiery now. Alright, we're gonna stay on that side. We're just gonna do a bit of a side plank movement before we move on to the other side, okay? So with this one, I'm gonna give you some different options. Take the option that works for you. All of them are just as hard as each other. I'm just gonna take some stretches first. So your right hand is down on the mat, underneath your shoulder. Your knees are together. All right, we're just gonna press up into the knee, lean over and take a nice stretch, opening out through that left side body and then come all the way down. Press into the right hand, stretch it over, and release. Two more. Last one, push up, hold, really stretch yourself right over, try not to round forward, keeping nice and level, and releasing off. All right, so we're gonna come into a full plank line, side plank. You're gonna stay with your right hand under. If you get sore wrists and it's already hurting, come onto your forearm and do the same thing on your forearm. And I'm gonna come into a full plank, but if you need to, at any point, drop the knees down. I'll show you when we're up here, okay? So, right hand's underneath the shoulder, fingertips drawing out away from your body. Really make sure the weight of your shoulder is over your wrists, and then take your legs nice and long. Your left leg, your top leg is gonna be in front, and your right is gonna be behind slightly. All right, when you're ready, press yourself all the way up, side plank. Okay, so your option, the knee's down, the left leg is long. Okay, cool. Holding here. We dip the hips and lift. Five. If you want to, take the hand long. Four. Take those options if you need. Three. Two. Lift, hold. Reach the fingertips to ceiling. Lift through the hips. Eye gaze forward. Five, four, three, two, and one. Nice. Shake those wrists out. And we're going to do that all over again on the other side. Okay. So this time, you're going to draw your left arm underneath your left elbow. Forearm first, legs are long to start. Right hand's on top, or if you need it for support, place it in front of your body. Your right leg lifts up, it draws a rainbow, top of the mat, and the bottom. Nice. So when you're here, keep moving through the leg. I want you to think about drawing the belly button in, really hold your core tight. That's helping you with this movement. Start using your breath if you're not already. Inhaling through the nose. Breathing out through the mouth like you're blowing out a candle. Last two. Last one. Bring that foot in front of your body. Nice. Keep that push out. So try not to get lazy through the side as you work into this one. Hand is on the hip or it's in front. Left leg lifts and lowers. Really subtle movement, just working that little inner thigh muscle while we can. Nice. Five, four, three, two, hold it up. Little pulses in the M range. Up and down, up and down. Press into that side, arm, left arm, five, four, three, two, one. All right, nice. All right, so this time we're gonna move into the clams. So your legs are together. Options with how you wanna set up the body, okay? So coming down, hand on the head, or lying down fully. So exactly the same as before. I want your right hand to be on top of your hip or bring it in front if you need it for balance. Draw the belly in. Try not to let the ribs flare out here, okay? Don't wanna see this, it's not cute. Draw it in. All right, lift the feet off the mat. We open and lower. Open and lower. Okay, imagine you're wrapping your ribs around the front of you. Or you're wrapping your obliques. That's probably the better way to look at it. All right, really think about the hip joint moving. Keep the feet lifted off the mat. Try not to let that top hip rotate forward. It is peachy indeed, Sorsh. All right, keep moving. Keep breathing. Three more. Last two. Last one. Top leg lifts, bottom leg stays off the mat. We press out and drawn in. Nice. Yeah, but worried I've got this drag song playing. Keep moving, I'm gonna change the song. Five more. Last three. Two. Hold the leg long, little circles. Really keep the belly button drawn in. Little dinner plates with your toes. Five. Four. Three. Two. Reverse. Do not come down, okay? It's meant to be so unbearably sore. I want you to get to that point that you literally cannot lift your leg off the ground. Five, four, three, two. Hold that leg up, slightly higher than the hip with the toes. Rotate the toes towards the ceiling. Flex your foot towards me, or towards your body, and then point. Flex. And point. Bottom leg is still lifted off the mat. Flexing and pointing. Five more. Four. Three. Last two. On one. Point and hold. Lift and lower. Little fire into that booty. Four. Three, last two, holding it up, flex the toes towards your face, hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, and we're out. Nice work, guys. All right, we've got that side plank on the side, then we're out of this position. Okay, so your left hand is under your shoulder. We're gonna take the stretch to start, okay? So we've just got the knees glued together. We're gonna press into the knees, press into that left hand, reach out and over, and coming all the way down. Fingertips are pointing away from your body. Slow down your breath. Let's go for one more, hold it up there. Stretch the body over. Reach for the far side of the room. And release. Okay, so exactly the same as we did on the other side. You've got your options. Forearm if you want a sore wrist. Otherwise, we're not up there for long. So if you do get wrist pain, I do recommend you do try and push through it a little bit. That's how they get stronger. I used to have terribly weak wrists. So do try to do it as much as you can, okay? Your right foot goes in front of your body, your left leg is slightly behind. They're really close together. If you need to, keep your left knee down on the mat. When you're ready, pressing into the feet, coming into that side plank, holding here. Hand can be on the hip, can be up, we dip. If it makes you guys feel better, I hate these. But hey, it's not as bad as on a reformer. 4, 3. Last two, hold up. Reach the fingertips long, belly button to spine. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Have a glass of water if you need it. We're gonna move right on. Okay. Core is already a little bit warm, but I just want to warm it up a bit more before we move into our proper core work. So can we come into a four-point kneel position? Can I go this way? Nice. So your hands are underneath your shoulders, knees are underneath your hips. Eye gaze is forward. Amazing. Okay, from here, I just want you to draw your left leg out, round it in towards your body, and as you do so, curl into a nice C shape. Then reach all the way back up, coming into a neutral spine. Bring the knee in towards your nose, curl the body up, and release. Three more here. Round into the spine, belly button pulls up, and release. Try to not sink into your right hip. Last two. Last one, reach that left leg nice and long. Your right hand is gonna come out long as well. So opposite arm reaches out. If that's too much, keep your right hand down. Okay, from here, I just want you to draw the left leg out towards the left-hand side of the room and back behind you. So slight diagonal and draw in. If you need to, keep the arms down. Just move the leg. Okay, so this is your option. If your wrists are too sore, okay, three more. Last two. And one. Hold it out on that diagonal. Reach your right hand out on a diagonal as well. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Releasing off. Other side straight away. Okay, so we're just keeping that core nice and warm before we move into our proper core work. Staying with your hands where they are, reaching that leg out nice and long. Right leg is reaching out. You curl through the body. Articulate the spine, grounding as your knee comes towards your nose, then stretching all the way back out. Drawing in, really think about your rounding over that ball. And then coming into a neutral spine. Three more. Last two. Slow down the breath. Last one. Press it all the way out. Hold. Try not to sink into the left side too much. Your right hand extends, your left hand extends out, sorry. If you want to take the option, draw the belly button in.
Right leg opens to the right hand side of the room. It draws behind you. Point those toes. Slow movement through the right leg. Challenging our balance here, switching on our core, front and back body. Last three, two, on one, we take that hold. Press it out, your left hand opens out slightly into the diagonal as well. Tuck the belly button in, five, four, three, two, and one. Let's just sink down into that child's pose, reach the fingers out nice and long. If you want to, you can bring the body up here, yeah, the bum up, sorry, the body down. All right, who is ready for core? Favorite part of class? So my mum says, if you're watching mum. Okay. And we did this sort of similar core work last week with the can. So we're walking into a similar part of the body. It takes some tension out of the neck, which I know lots of people don't love. But what it can do is put some tension into your hips. So if you have tight hips, try and do this if you can. Or walk your feet out a bit further if you need to. Otherwise, just come and take a break when you need to and join us. But try to stay with me for the whole set. I know it is. Feet are flat on the mat. I want you to have about 2 to 3 handprints between your heel and your bum. All right. You should be able to feel those hip flexors flaring a little bit already. I really want you to sit up through the back. Really sink onto those tailbones, okay? You should be able to feel the sit bones rocking from side to side. Hands are going to come out in front of you, palms facing each other. At any point the hands get too much, cross the hands across the body. Alright, really sit up nice and tall, something you're very terrible at. Alright, drop the shoulders away from the ears, round into the lower spine. Coming down into a C-curve shape, get to a point before your feet lift off the mat and then re-step yourself all the way up. All right, keep moving through this at your own pace, okay? So don't have to follow my pace with this one. I just want you to roll down and sit back up right onto those tailbones. I know the strike, it's I've had too much going. I mean, it's all good. I'll just do voiceover. And coming up. Let's go for one more. Come all the way back up. And rolling down, we hold. I want you to take your ideas to your fingertips. You're gonna follow your left fingers as your left hand opens out to the left hand side of the room. It closes. Right hand. Okay, so your body is not, your legs and hips are not moving. You're just moving the arms and upper rib cage. Keep breathing here. Inhale through the nose. Keep that nice C-curve shape through the spine. One more to the right-hand side. Hold through center. Can you drop a little lower back? Both hands are going to open. Eye gaze stays forward. Close the hands. Oh yeah, that one burns. Let's go. Four more. Feet are flat on the mat. Breathing. Shoulders drawn down away from the ears. Last two. Last one. Open out. Draw them shut. Hold here. Can you drop a little lower? A little lower. A little lower. And re-stack all the way up. Roll over the body. Hug the knees into the chest if you need to. All right, we've got another set. How's everyone feeling? Good? Okay. All right, so exactly the same. This time you're gonna be moving the legs, not the arms, okay? So sitting up nice and tall, find those sit bones. We're going to make that C-curve with the body, so no warm-up this time. Rounding in, draw the belly button in, always hunch the shoulders forward, okay? You want to draw your chin slightly to your chest, but imagine you're trying to hold a ball between your chin and your chest. I don't want you to be like this. Okay, so holding your nice tennis ball between your chin and chest. Hands are out in front of you, drop the shoulders down, open them out slightly wider than your legs. Your left leg comes into a tabletop position, it drops down to the mat. Right leg comes up, it drops down. Breathing here. Keep moving the legs. I'm going to cue you through breath. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, left leg lowers. Inhale, leg lifts. Exhale to lower. Two more on each side. One more each side. All right, your left leg is gonna come up. You're gonna hold it here. Right leg comes to meet it. You're in teaser. Sit up a little taller through the spine. Hands come up a little higher. If you can, extend the legs long. We're in your full teaser. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop the heels down. Reach for your toes. Breathe it out. All right. Nice work, guys. We're all done. We're just going to have a stretch to finish. Okay. I'm just going to get you to lie on your backs. Hope you're all feeling okay. All right, we're going to lie on our backs. Let's stretch out those glutes first. We got those pretty hard today, okay? So you're gonna cross your left heel across your right leg. Take your hands, draw them underneath your right leg and pull that shape towards you. Close your eyes if you can here. Draw your rib cage in. Inhaling through your nose. As you exhale, press that left knee away from your body a little deeper. Inhale through your nose. Exhale, press into that stretch a little deeper. Last deep inhale in. Exhale. Switch the legs over. Okay, so your right leg's gonna cross over your left. Hands thread through, grab that left leg, pull that shape towards you. If you want, you can crouch the upper body here to get a bit more if that's better for you. Otherwise, close those eyes. Nice deep inhale through the nose. Exhale, press into that right knee, draw it away from your body. Inhale. Exhale, blowing out a candle. Last deep inhale through the nose. Exhale, press that knee away. And release. Sit yourself up. Bring the backs of the feet together. Let's work out those inner thighs and into those hips, a little butterfly stretch. Hands come onto the feet. Press those knees down towards the mat. Close the eyes again if you need to here. It's quite nice for the breath. Draw your rib cage in. Breathing in through the nose. As you exhale, deepen the stretch. Press the knees closer to the mat. Inhaling through the nose. Exhale, press those knees a little deeper. One more breath. Deep breath in. And out. Opening the eyes. One more stretch for the hip flexors. Okay, so coming into a kneeling position. I'm gonna do it sideways. Your right leg comes forward underneath your foot is underneath your knee. Hands can be on the hips, wherever is more comfortable. Feel where those hip flexors are, and then I just want you to press your body forward. So press the bum forward until you feel a stretch to the left front of your leg. Should be in there. Holding here. Nice deep inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. One more deep breath in. And out. Coming back. Other side, left leg comes forward. All right, press the body forward. Keep the belly tucked in, really feel that stretch through the front of your right leg this time. Nice deep inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Last one. Inhaling through your nose. And all the way out. We are done.
Well done, guys. Thanks so much for joining me today. Hope you have a good Sunday night if you're at home, or Sunday afternoon if you're in Singers. See you later.